So some of you may ask, how on earth does a pandemic affect the world's food supply? However, this can actually happen because the pandemic affects other things, which then in turn affects the food supply. And to be honest, the pandemic is actually getting worse, so the food supply situation may too deteriorate. Let's take a look at what's actually going on. If we look at this article, it states, unless immediate action is taken, it is increasingly clear that there is an impending global food emergency that could have long-term impacts on hundreds of millions of children and adults. We need to act now to avoid the worst impacts of our efforts to control the pandemic. Although harvests of staple crops are holding up, the export bans and protectionism that experts have feared have so far been largely avoided. The worst of the impacts of the pandemic and the ensuing recession are yet to be felt. So even in countries with abundant of food, we see risks of disruption in the food supply chain. So what's going to happen here is that the pandemic actually affects worldwide economies. Different restrictions have to be in place, and different countries no longer export certain goods and may have different restrictions on what comes in and out of the country. Because of this, food may need to be produced locally, and on top of that, there are many people who are starting to hoard food in fears of a second wave, meaning that there is less food on these shelves. Now, if we look firstly at what happened in the Western world, we can see that the first wave of coronavirus actually put in a huge wave of fear. We know that toilet paper and kitchen towels were flying off the shelves in every Western country. This was something that many people didn't predict. Many people were stocking up on long-term food supplies such as beans, tuna, and anything you could get in a can. This was something that was out of fear and was quite irrational. As we know, humans operate on a emotional basis, and with a pandemic out of nowhere, many people feared we would be locked down for many months and many years. However, we've noticed that this may not be the case, but if we look here, you can see that the pandemic is actually starting to worsen. Let's take a look at the daily cases in the United States. You can see that approaching winter, the graph looks as if there may be a second wave on the rise. And this isn't just in the United States. Among the Western world and in European countries, this is a similar trend. Take a look at the United Kingdom. The graph was pretty low when there was a first wave of fear, but as we move into September, the graph is exponentially increasing, which is worrying. And not just in the United Kingdom, other European countries too. Italy, once again, the graph's increasing. And if we look at Germany, things are going back to the first wave levels, which isn't good for anyone. Because if we are locked down for a second time, this may once again prompt fears, and once again, people may act irrationally and get food from the shelves that they don't really need. When I was personally trying to shop during the pandemic, it was almost impossible to get my hands on some basic necessities because many people have taken more than they actually needed, meaning that there are lots of people who have more than they need and lots of people who have less than they need. And I mean a lot less people who have more than they need. So it's a very, very bad situation. And many countries are probably going to be imposing another lockdown if these cases continue to rise. Now, this isn't the only factor affecting the global food shortage. You see, the global food shortage is actually a process which involves many countries. You see, the majority of Western world can't actually produce the goods that we like to consume on a global scale. Actually import the majority of our foods from third world countries and countries abroad. However, if we look at this article right here, what it continues to say is that lockdowns are slowing harvests. While millions of seasonal laborers are unable to work, food waste has reached damaging levels, with farmers forced to dump perishable produce as the result of supply chain problems, and the meat industry plants have been forced to close in some countries. Even before lockdowns, the global food system was failing in many areas, according to the United Nations. The report basically points to conflict, natural disasters, and the climate crisis, and the arrival of pests and plant and animal plagues as already existing problems. And if you've been paying attention to the news, you'll know that Africa did have the worst locust swarms that it's seen in decades. As the news continues, the global food shortage is going to be something we won't see straight away. It's going to be something we see happen over a slower period of time. Like I said, the pandemic has some direct straightaway impacts and things that you can immediately see, such as some businesses going straight out of business, but some effects such as those on the economy, the housing market, and the global food supply will have a longer effect to catch up. This is what is known as data that lags because it isn't seen straight away. It's seen later on as the days progress, or as time progresses, meaning it's harder to see and harder to predict. As you can see here, this article from the Wall Street Journal states that a food crisis is worsening around the world as the coronavirus pandemic drags on. The pandemic has doubled the number of people who are acutely food insecure, said the chief economist at the United Nations World Food Programme, from 135 million people in 2019 to 270 million. So, we have hunger going up, we have poverty going up, we have unemployment going up, and we have incomes going down, and we have prices going up. All of this put together means that lots of people in this world can no longer afford a decent meal. The world hasn't seen such a shock to both food supplies and food demand on a global scale in the past century. The pandemic arrived at time of bountiful harvest and ample food supplies, but the trade disruptions and breakdowns in processing and transport have left millions hungry in the worst struck regions. So this is something that we know is pretty bad because the pandemic is affecting the world and it's not going away. You see, initially people thought that the lockdowns could eventually eliminate the coronavirus. But with many countries that still are allowing flights to go to and from each other and are allowing and lifting restrictions on masks, it seems that the coronavirus may be here to stay until we do get that final silver bullet, such as a vaccine. Also, a report indicated that global food prices could keep climbing, making the adequate... making adequate nutrition more expensive as millions are thrown out of work and economic woes deepen. So, the United Nations released its gauge of global food prices, which shows the cost rose 2.1% in September, mainly driven by grains and vegetable oils. So, prices are rising as the world is forecast for a sharp rise in food insecurity because of the COVID-19 impact. So as you can see, there are tons of factors and many different things going on here. And it's actually difficult to see how this will pan out. Because food isn't something that's like the economy. It's something that takes a while to produce and there's an entire supply chain built around this industry. And food needs to be effectively distributed or millions of people can be left out of. As we continue, we know that social distancing measures have had an impact on the cost of food production. For example, packing centers may have had to reduce the number of staff working and therefore their productivity. Lorries may have had one driver rather than two and therefore have to stop for breaks, increasing the time it takes to transport food. We've already seen one or two food companies go out of production, and the financial pressures on the supply chains are real. So we do know that the food supply isn't in a great place. And as the pandemic worsens, I don't think we're going to see things get better.